I was first diagnosed with diabetes when I was about 6.5 years old. And at the time, I didn't fully understand what was going on. I didn't comprehend that this would be something that would, you know, last for the rest of my lifetime. You know, eventually I learned to manage my own diabetes and give myself my shots, and I knew that I was different from the other children. And, you know, it was something that sometimes I would feel down about, but other times I would be very proud of my difference. Growing up was, you know, it was quite lonely being the only diabetic in my school. And I didn't have a great community as far as my friends go, but being at the Endocrine and Diabetes Care Center, they gave me the resources to participate in things like summer camps and day camps, and I made friends for life through those things, and that definitely helped me feel less alone. If I could give advice to families struggling to manage their child's diabetes or their own diabetes, it would be, you know, you have to be your own advocate. You can go to the doctor on, you know, every 3 months and do what they tell you to do, but, you know, that's only part of it. You really have to do your research and know your own body. And pay attention to the quality of the food you're eating and your quality of your lifestyle. So definitely be your own advocate. You are the number one person in your own care. Your doctor is there to help you, but you're in charge. The diabetes educators and my own endocrinologist, Dr. Delameter, you know, they definitely had an impact on me growing up. I was a troubled kid and, you know, was trying to rebel against the world when really the only person I was rebelling against was myself, you know. But they saw through that and they understood my frustration and what I was going through, and they never gave up on me. And that's, I'm grateful for that. They went above and beyond. They were not just health professionals. I mean, they were mentors and friends and people who genuinely cared about me, not just as a patient, but as one of their own. Things that I do differently now in managing my diabetes as opposed to when I was younger is pretty much everything. I mean, I checked my blood sugar and took insulin then, but you know, my parents could only teach me what they knew, and you know, with the internet now and having the access to all kinds of information, I now know more about what I should be eating, my diet, and what types of exercise are better, you know, for controlling blood sugar. And I mean, I do a lot of things differently now. I wear a glucose sensor and an insulin pump, whereas I used to take shots and you know, didn't have the level of accuracy that I have now. I'm not perfect by any means, but I try to fit exercise into my schedule whenever I can. My favorite thing to do is yoga because it's low impact, it's relaxing, and it's great for overall cognitive abilities and health, and just, you know, let the stress go, and your blood sugar will be better. Music was definitely cathartic. You know, it was a way for me to express, you know, whatever I was going through and in my life. You know, not just with dealing with being a type 1 diabetic, but, you know, family issues and home issues. And if I hadn't had music, I don't know where I would be now. So music has definitely been my saving grace. While I was on American Idol, the schedules were quite intense. I mean, we would wake up before the sun was up and then be in sessions all day and doing interviews and press and rehearsals. And I mean, oftentimes I would wake up and be out the door and not have a minute to even check my blood sugar. And, you know, I also wasn't necessarily making that the priority because I was so caught up in what was happening with the show. You know, and I quickly learned that that was a mistake. My blood sugar was running high for a few days, and it caught up to me, and I ended up, you know, being admitted with DKA. I wasn't bolusing for meals because I had to eat so quickly and then get on to the next thing that I would end up forgetting. And I also didn't want to tell the producers that I was type 1 because I didn't want to be treated any differently than the rest of the contestants. And once I got sick, it was a huge wake-up call. And then I was given so many resources that I really needed and just didn't have the courage to ask for. So in a way, that was one of the best things that ever happened to me. And because I became sick, you know, in a public way, it automatically made me a spokeswoman for people living with type 1 and diabetes in general. The Falzone Diabetes Center is going to be such an immense resource for this community. I mean, diabetes in general has become an epidemic, and people are still confused about what it actually is or what it means for their life. You know, some folks think that they can just take a pill and everything's going to be okay, but that's not the case, and people will hopefully come here to get that education and learn to manage their diabetes. You can give someone insulin or medication and they'll be okay, but if you give them the knowledge, it's, you know, it's like teaching a man to fish or giving him a fish. The Falzone Diabetes Center is going to be a wonderful thing for people to learn how to take care of themselves.